A very good morning to everyone. Today we are going to start exercise 2F. Yesterday we have discussed till question 4th. Today we will discuss in question 5th, 6th and 7th. First of all, and how we can multiply with 10, 100 and 1000 with the decimals. Okay? Now let's start with the questions. Can we take your seat properly? Question 5th is, divide each of the following decimal with 10. You have to divide with 10. Okay? Divide by 10. Suppose your first part is 15.03 divided by 10. Okay? So how we can write this equation? First of all, I'm going to write this first term as 1503 divided by 100. Can I write? I have removed the decimal. Decimal is before two digits and I have written here in the denominator 100. That is two zeros. Right? I'm going to remove this division sign. I'm going to put here multiply sign. Can I write? Okay. If I write here multiply sign, what will be my next term? Quickly. If I am writing here multiply sign, what will be my next term? Next term. How I can write the next term? Quickly. Yes, very good. Very good. Next term will be reciprocal. It will be 1 upon 10. Only this is the main step of the question. Of question 5th, 6th and 7th. Right? Priyansh, Joshi and Akshara. When will you adjust the camera? When will you take your seats properly? By tomorrow? Now, you have to cancel the term. You can, if see to it, if any term you can cancel, you can reduce into the lowest form. Otherwise, take out your answer. So, I am writing here 1503. I can't cancel any term. I am writing here 100 into 10. That is 1000. So, my answer will be, there are three zeros in the denominator. So my answer will be 1.503. Okay? You have to place the decimal before three digits because there are three zeros in the denominator. Any doubt is there in this question? It is very, very easy. How we can divide with 10? Okay? Now, I'm doing one more part. Suppose there is a third part. That is 0.75. Okay, divide with 10. So first of all, remove the decimal. That will be 75 upon 100. Okay, now here, this will be, I'm going to put here multiply sign in place of division. Now, next term will be reciprocal. Okay, see to it. If you will cancel, you can cancel it. Otherwise, you can take out your answer. I can cancel also, but I'm writing answer in this way, 75 upon 1000. It will be more easy for me to take out the answer in decimals. Okay, there are three zero in the denominator. So in the numerator, I'm having only two digits. So I have to place one more digit. Okay, that is zero. So decimal will be there before three digits, 1, 2 and 3. Okay, now I'm going to unmute some students in the class. I'm going to ask you, how we can do the next part. Next question is question 6th. Right? I'm going to unmute some students. Be attentive in the class. Sixth question is divide by 100. Divide by 100. Okay. Tanisha, just wait. Akshit. 7th Florence, please unmute yourself.
Good morning, ma'am.
Very good morning. Please tell me, Akshit, here I am going to divide by 100. Okay, my question is 352.6 divided by 100. First of all, how I can write my first term?
Ma'am, 3526 upon 10.
Very good. Why 10? Before decimal is? Because decimal is?
Because decimal is before one number.
Very good. Very good. Now, in the next step, I am going to remove the
divide sign and put multiplier sign.
Very good. The next term will be?
Ma'am, reciprocal.
Very good. What will be?
1/100.
Very nice. Very nice. So, now, in the next step, what I will write in the numerator? What should I write in the numerator? 3526 multiplied by 1. It will be?
3526.
Very good. In the denominator, how many zeros?
Ma'am,
1000 will come. Very good. Now, after that, answer will be?
3.526.
Very good. Why? Because there are 3 zeros. So, decimal I have to place before how many digits?
3
digits. Very nice. It's understood to you?
Yes, ma'am.
Absolutely correct. Now, please mute yourself. So, everyone got this concept the way he has told? Very good. Yes, Shaurya? Yes. Okay. Now, the next question, next part I'm doing. One more part I'm doing. That is, suppose second part. 4.8 divided by 100. My answer will be 48. First of all, the first step is 48 divided by 10. Okay. I am going to remove division sign. I am going to put here multiply. Next term will be reciprocal. Okay. 48 into 1, 48. 10 into 100, 1000. And you can take out your answer in decimal. That is 0.048. It's understood to everyone? Very good. Okay. Now, I am going to unmute other student now. Next question is question 7. That is divided by 1000. Divided by 1000. Okay, so be active in the class. First part is 4397.46 divided by 1000. Right? Akshara. Akshara, please unmute yourself quickly. Akshara Sachdeva. Yes. Akshara, tell me, what should I write in the first term? How I can write this first term? Akshara? My voice is audible to you. Check your settings quickly. Some disturbance is there, no worries. Next turn will be off. Okay, Devansh. Devansh, unmute yourself quickly. Devansh, I've sent a message. See to it. Next turn will be of Jay Vardhan. Yeah, good afternoon.
Good morning, ma'am.
Who is this?
I'm Jayavardhan.
Jayavardhan. Okay, very good morning. Okay, now please tell me how I can write this first term.
M 43974 6 upon 100.
Okay, 4 divided by 100. By 100?
Ma'am, there was a 1000
decimal. Decimal is before 2 digits.
Yes,
that's why divided by 100. Now I have to remove this the division sign. What should I write here?
Multiplication.
Now next term will be, next term, how I can write next term? Very good, very good. Please mute yourself.
Okay.
Okay, very good. Now the next will be, in the next step, you have to multiply numerator with 1. That will be 439746 divided by 100 with the 100 with 1000, that will be 5 zeros, 1 lakh. Okay, now write down in your answer. Answer will be, decimal should be there before 5 digits. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That is 4.39746. This is your answer. Any doubt is there? Siddharth, very good. Any doubt is there? Okay. Now, let me ask one more student. Pratishtha. Pratishtha, seventh blossom. Please unmute yourself quickly. I'm going to write here 0.8 divided by 1000. Next term will be of Shreya. Shreya, seventh blossom. Very good morning. Please tell me how I can write this first term. Okay. This I have to remove division. What should I write here?
Multiply.
Okay. Next term will be. Okay. Now, 8 multiplied by 1. Divided by 10 into 1000. Okay, answer will be what?
Ma'am, answer will be before 8 there will be 4 zeros and then decimals.
Before 8 there will be how many zeros?
4.
No. How many zeros? Think once again. There should be 3 zeros. Because decimal should be there before 4 digits. One digit is already there. 8 is there. Okay? Okay? Please mute yourself. One digit is already present here. So you have to place 3 more zeros. Okay? Understood by everyone? Okay? So it will be 0.0008. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now these are total 4 digits. Including 8. Right? Okay? So in this way, you have to solve all the parts of question 5th, 6th and 7th. Quickly mark these questions. Quickly. In your book, first of all. Everyone. On Monday, I'll ask everyone. I'll unmute some students. Okay, and I'll ask you. Okay, no worries. I'm doing one more part. Some are having doubt in the 6th part. I'm doing 6th part here. Okay. So be ready, I'm going to unmute some student. Whenever I'm going to unmute anyone, please be sure that disturbance should not be there from your side. Okay, Siddharth. Siddharth, unmute yourself. Very good morning. Siddharth, tell me, in the 6th part, there is 3 divided by 1000. So what is my first term?
Ma'am, 3 upon 1000.
3 upon, very good. First term is not having any decimal. So it will be 3 only. Okay, this is multiply. This will be
1 upon 1000.
Or I can write 3 ones are 3 upon 1000. Okay, now please tell me the answer.
Ma'am, 0.003.
0.003. Why? Because there is 1000 and decimal should be there before how many digits?
Ma'am, three digits.
Decimal should be there before 3 digits. Very nice. This is your answer. Please mute yourself quickly. It's understood by everyone? Question 5th, 6th and 7th. In question 5th, divided by 10. Question 6th, divide by 100. Question 7th, divide by 1000. Very, very easy. Okay? Raghav Rana, 7th Florence. Adjust your camera quickly. And sit properly in the class. Yes, Tanisha, you can divide directly also. But the main concept is you have to go along with the steps. Okay? I'll check the papers. I'm only giving the marks according to the steps. Okay? So when you will write your question with proper steps, you will I'll be very short. If you will write directly, okay, sometime mistakes can be possible. So please write your question with proper step. Okay, I can also do this question in one line. So some students will not get the question that how ma'am has done this question in one line. Okay, step by step only you will get the question. Similarly, step by step I'll get your solution in your paper. Okay, I'll able to know that how much you know the concept. All right, just hold on. Geet, that we'll discuss after the class. Okay. All right, now let's start with the word problem questions. Question 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13 and 14. All are based upon the word problem. Siddharth, 7th awesome. I'm going to remove you from the class immediately. Right? I don't want any disturbance in my class. Any disturbance. It's a last warning. Disha Lathar, take your seat properly. 7th Florence. Next question is question 8. In all these questions, whatever the terms are given to you, you have to divide the terms. That's it. But the main step is how you are writing the statement. Grammatical errors should not be there. Okay? Grammatical errors should not be there. Question 8. The thickness of 50 sheets of paper is 9 mm. Okay. The thickness of 50 sheets. Thickness of 50 sheets are given is equals to 9 mm. Okay. These are units. Okay. They are saying that find out the thickness of one sheet. Very simple. One sheet. Answer will be how you have to write down the question. Siddharth. Yes. 9. It's 9. Ananya, it's 9. 9 divided by 50. 9 divided by 50. Now you can divide. 9 will be here. 50 will be here. Okay. So it is not going on 50 table, I'm putting here decimal. So automatically 0 will come. 50 ones are 50. Okay. What will be left? 40. Okay. If I have placed decimal, so automatically 110 can come by on. Okay. So 0, I can write here 0. Okay. Now 50 multiplied by how much? 50 multiplied by how much? So that it will be 400. Quickly, very good. 50 multiplied by 8, that will be 400. Okay, so your answer is equals to 0.18 mm. Okay, this is the answer. Thickness of 50 sheets are given. Thickness of one sheet will be divide the term. That's it. Okay, if I'm giving you question in the paper that will be of the word problem, I will check the statement first of all, how you have made the statement. Okay, how you have made the statement. Adarsh Lathar, this is a camera, not a mirror. Now next question is, please mark the question side by side. I'm giving you question. In 9th question also you have to divide, right? In the 10th question also you have to divide. Okay. Yes, one more thing. In your previous question, they are saying that find out the, in 8th question, they are saying that find out the question answer in the centimeter. Okay, I have taken out answer. My answer was 0.18 mm. Okay, they are saying that find out the answer in centimeter. So how we can convert mm into centimeter? You just have to divide. Divide with 10. You just have to divide with 10. Okay, so your answer will be already how much we are having. I'm writing in this way. Divide with 10. The way we have done 5th, 6th and 7th question. Okay, so how I can write 18 upon 100 multiplied by 1 upon 10. So it will be 18 upon 1000. It will be 0.018 centimeter. Okay, in this question, 8th question, you have to take out your answer in centimeter. So you have to divide your question, whatever your answer has come, divide with 10. Okay, and how you have to write this? You have to write in the way that we have done in 5th, 6th and 7th question. Remove, multiply, reciprocal the next term, multiply numerator and then denominator, and then put the decimal. Easy? Okay, now let's start question. Please mark question 9th is your homework. You have to divide only in question 9th. But thing is how you are writing the statement. Right? Question 10th also, again you have to divide. That's it. You have to divide your, whatever terms are given, you have to divide. Mark question 10th also. Quickly. Question 11, I'm going to start here. Question 11th is, the product of two numbers are given. Product of two numbers are given. That is equals to how much? 2.4624. Okay? And they are saying that if one number is equals to, that is 0.57, then find out the other number. Other number you can write, or you can write down second number that you have to find out. Okay, product of two numbers given, one number is given, find out the other number or the second number. Okay, according to the question we know that product of two numbers are always equals to A into B. Product of first number multiplied with the second number. Okay, product of two numbers given, 2.4624 is equals to, first number is given, 0.57 multiplied by second number is not given. Let's suppose as B. Okay, now this will go in division of this. Okay, 2.4624 divided by 0.57 is equals to B, right? You can remove the decimal of the first term. 24624 divided by 1234, 4 zeros, multiply. This will be here, 57 will be here. When I remove decimal, number of zeros will go in numerator, right? Dutch 7th florins. Adjust your camera quickly. Adjust it. So your two zeros and two zeros will get cancelled. You have to divide 24624 with 57. Cancel on 3 table. Okay. And your answer will be, you can get your answer. Answer will be 432. When you will cancel on 3 table, your answer will be 432. Divide by 100 is left. Answer will be 4.32. This will be your answer. Nothing is difficult in this question, Angel. It is very, very easiest question. Product of two numbers given. One number is this. Find out the second number. So we know that product of two numbers is equals to first number multiplied by second number. Okay. Product is given. First number is given, second number is not given. Write down as B. Tanisha. Okay, now 2.4624, this will go in division of this, and B will be here only. B will be here only, okay. When I shift this here, I have to remove decimals first of all. Okay, when I remove decimal of this first term, how many zeros will go in denominator? 1, 2, 3, 4. 10,000 will go. Okay, this is in division of this, 57. When I remove decimal of this, the number of zeros will go in numerator. Here, zeros will come in denominator, and of this term, zeros will go in the numerator. So, two zeros and two zeros will get cancelled. This I can cancel on 3 table or 9 table or 57. It will be 432 divided by 100, divide by 100. So, 100 means decimal will come before 2 digits. Understood, Angel? Kartike, kindly sit properly in the class. It's understood by everyone? I'll tell you one thing. In one step, students are confused. Suppose it is 2.4 divided by 5.2. Suppose, okay, how the zeros will go up and down. Okay, this means 2.4 means 2.4 and 5.2 means multiply by 1 upon 5.2. Right? This means 2.4 I have written as it is. This division means multiply by 1 upon 5.2. Or I can write divide by 5.2. I am writing here multiply. This term will be reciprocal. 5.2. Now understood? Angel Goyal? Now understood? Okay. This term divide by 5.2 means divide by 5.2. Division means I am writing here multiply. This term will be reciprocal. When I remove decimal of this term, it will be 24 upon 10. When I remove decimal of this term, this will be 52 and 10 will go in the numerator. Okay? The decimal of the numerator, that will come in denominator. The decimal of the denominator, that will go in the numerator always. They are always going in reverse position. Pathniti, 7th awesome. Can you sit properly? And it's the last warning. Take it seriously. Now the next question is, this was the question 11th. Okay. Next question, question 12th. Please mark it properly. Question 11th. Absolutely simple. You have to do the division only. Right? You have to do the division only. Tanish, adjust your camera quickly. Now the next question, question 13 and question 14. Both are absolutely simple. I'm doing question 13 first of all. Okay. They're saying that a school uniform, question 13. A school uniform requires 1.5 meter clothes. Okay, 1.5 meter clothes. How many uniforms can be prepared from 23 meter cloth? Okay, so length of cloth required, length of cloth required for school uniform that is equals to 1.15 meter. Okay, and the total length is given. How many uniforms can be prepared? They are having this much cloth. Okay, total cloth, the quantity of cloth, amount of cloth they are having, that is 23 meter. Okay, and for one uniform they need this much cloth. For one uniform they have to make a uniform. Okay, for one student that required 1.15 meter. The amount of cloth they are having, that is 23 meter. Okay, they are saying that find out the how many uniforms can be prepared from this much cloth. So you have to divide. You have to find out number of uniforms. You have to find out number of uniforms we can prepare. Okay, and total cloth they are having, that is 23 meter. Okay, so answer, how you can find out number of uniforms, how you can find out how much is the total cloth, that is 23, and how much cloth required for one uniform, that is 1.15. that's it. Okay, so I'm writing this in this way, 23 divided by 1.15. 23 I'm writing here multiply, this will go in reciprocal, 1.15. Or I'm going to remove decimal. How many zeros will come in numerator? 2 zeros. Okay, now you can cancel your term. This you can cancel on 5 table. 5 2s are, 5 3s are. Okay, then you can cancel on 5 2s are and 0. 23 1s are, 23 1s are. So that is equals to 20. So 20 uniforms you can prepare from this much cloth. That is your answer. Siddharth, very good. Any doubt is there? Mehak, Tanisha, any doubt is there? This is the total cloth, total amount, the total quantity of cloth was given. Okay, from this cloth, this is the cloth required to make one uniform. So how many number of uniforms are possible? So you just have to divide the total cloth with the one cloth, one uniform. Okay, and the way you have to write 23, division sign means division, and I'm writing 1.15. I'm going to remove this division. I'm writing here multiply. This will go in the reciprocal, and then you can remove decimal. You can take out the answer. Right? Angel, Latter, Seventh, Awesome. Is it clear to you? Siddharth, Seventh Blossom. Is it clear to you? Okay. Vanshika, Seventh Blossom. Are you getting the concept of division with the decimals? Siddharth, fine. Okay, Aradhya, Seventh Awesome. Right, so now the last question is question 14. You have to do these questions from the home. Okay, this is your homework. 5th, 6th and 7th question are very easy. 9, 10th and 12th question are word problem. In all these questions, you have to apply only division. Okay, the concept is that how you are writing the statement in your solution. Okay, Tanveer Chaudhary, sit properly. Raghav Rana, sit properly in the class. Question 14th. If 58 buckets of equal capacity can be filled with 504.6 liters of water, then what is the capacity of each bucket? Okay, number of buckets are given in the question. Number of buckets are given in the question, that is 58 buckets are given. Total quantity of water these buckets are having, total amount or total quantity of water? Total quantity of water they are having, that is 504.6 liters. Okay, you have to find out the capacity of each bucket. Capacity of each bucket. Capacity of each bucket. So the same simple it is, you whenever we have to find out the capacity of anything, okay, you have to divide the total quantity with the number of that things. Okay, if these are bucket, these are the number of shirts, number of toffees, number of anything. Okay, so you have divided total quantity, that is 504.6, with the number of the things given to you, that is 58. In this way you can find out the capacity of each bucket. Okay, Shreya, sit properly. Now this is equals to 504.6 divided by 58. 5046, I'm going to remove decimal, it will be 10 and multiply by 1 upon 58. Okay, 58, then I'll cancel this 58 with 5046, it will directly cancel on 87. So it is equals to 87 divided by 10, so that is equals to 8.7. So capacity of each bucket is 8.7 liter. This is your answer. Any doubt? Any doubt you're having in this division concept? Right? Fine, Siddharth. Okay. So today we have completed our last exercise and some questions I have given for the homework. Okay. So today's homework is, please try to complete your notebook till chapter 2. Till chapter 2. Okay. On Monday, you have to submit your maths PDF to me. On Monday, you have to submit your maths PDF to me properly. okay, everyone, all the sections, right? So you are having, today you are having Friday, Saturday, Sunday, do complete your work till chapter 2. Those who have sent, I have written their names, I am having that record. Those who have not sent, they have to send me this till chapter 2, your PDFs, right? So today do complete this work, first of all in your practice notebook, match your answers and then go for the fieldwork. Alright, bye bye and take care all of you.